The Redeemer's Coming, The Sherlock Holmes Advent Calendar, by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle and Nora Godwin, narrated by Bryan Godwin. Part 24, Damnation and Redemption. While the fire was still burning strong and slowly raised the abbey to the ground, I looked for a means of transport. Some firefighters were leading the horses, donkeys, and their interbreedings out of the stables, to which the flames would surely soon spread. It was with great relief that I took note of the rescue of my former companion Harry. Nevertheless, for all the symbolic elegance towards the Virgin Mary on the way to Bethlehem, we could not expect our Mariah to ride on a donkey. But the heavily pregnant, unconscious woman urgently needed to be taken to a hospital if she and her unborn child were to survive. It was no one less than Pope Leo XIII who indirectly sent help, when suddenly a magnificent closed carriage with two white horses drawing it came to a halt in front of us. The coachman climbed from his seat and opened the door of the car. An older man in cardinal garb stepped out of it, followed by a young adjutant. It had to be Monsignor Fasanova, the papal envoy, who, on behalf of the Holy Father, was to look after the rite in the Redeemer's Abbey. Disbelief gripped his face when he saw the blazing fire. He shook his head and looked around helplessly. Then he came to us. "I am Bernardo Fasanova," he confirmed my suspicion, "apostolic delegate of His Holiness the Pope, and I want to know what happened here." We didn't really know what to say, and Holmes said, "Welcome to the Redeemer's Abbey, most venerable eminence. Unfortunately, not much of it is left. My name is Sherlock Holmes. I am an investigator on behalf of Scotland Yard and Cardinal Manning. The good news is that we have solved the murder cases and rendered the perpetrators harmless. The bad news is you will need a new abbot." "And a new abbey, it seems to me," Fasanova added in a serious voice. "What about Brother Francis? Can I speak to him?" "I regret," Holmes replied. "He's dead." "Can I see his deputy?" asked the envoy from Rome. Holmes shook his head. "Sorry," he replied. "Brother Peter is also dead." "For heaven's sake," cried Fasanova. "Is there any survivor in charge here?" "It's going to be best," Holmes replied, pointing in the appropriate direction, "if you turn to Brother Paul with confidence. He kept a cool head in difficult conditions and was instrumental in the investigation of the local conspiracy against the Catholic Church. A good man." "I understand," said the envoy, approaching the monk, who at first was a little intimidated, but then cheerful. "Meanwhile, I had to draw attention again to our urgent problem." "What are we doing with Mariah now?" I cried. "She needs to go to a hospital right away, otherwise her chances of survival will be close to zero." "We'll take the delegate's carriage," suggested Lestrade immediately. "This will be the quickest and safest. We can reach the Queen Charlotte Hospital within 45 minutes if the papal horses are fast enough." I nodded in agreement, and together with the inspector, I carefully lifted the improvised stretcher to get Mariah into the car. However, the adjutant Fasanova's stood in our way. "What do you intend to do?" he asked with a dark look. "I'm a doctor," I explained, "and this patient must be transported immediately to a hospital. If you allow, we would like to use your carriage for this." "I don't allow anything," the young man replied. "Listen," replied Lestrade animatedly, "this is a police operation. This carriage is hereby confiscated by the authorities. Step aside." When the adjutant still did not react, Holmes approached him from behind and pushed him vigorously in the back, causing him to fall headlong into the snow. "Oh, pardon, how rude of me," said Holmes, opening the car door. Quickly and yet cautiously, we lifted Mariah into the carriage and placed her on the well-padded bench. Holmes and I climbed into the inside of the car, while Lestrade climbed onto the carriage and took the reins. "Avanti," he shouted, driving the two horses, who immediately ran off. We heard the delegate's adjutant swearing in Italian, and since I was not fully aware of the content of the curse, I asked, "What did he say? Was there anything with damnation?" "I think," Holmes replied, smiling, "he just wanted to wish us a good trip." With this, we left the still-burning abbey behind us and set off with all haste on the way to Hammersmith. The hospital doctor...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.